The Jackrabbit football team opens up the 2018 season in a little more than a week, September the 1st at Iowa State. We continue our GoJacks.com positional breakdowns by focusing on the defensive tackles with Coach Christian Smith, who says the effort and attitude from the guys so far has been great to see.
Everything's been going really well so far. The guys working hard, getting in shape, transitioning from the summer into football shape, so they're doing a good job trying to be physical and take care of their bodies. Pleased so far with what we've done.
Smith joined the Jackrabbit coaching staff in February of 2017, arriving in time to coach the tackles throughout spring ball a year ago. Getting to know the guys during that period is something he says has helped quite a bit through his first year and a half on the job.
It was an easy transition for me. When you got a great group of coaches and a great group of kids, it makes it a lot easier. They bought in right away to what I was teaching them, and it's easygoing guys. And really developed over the last year. So it's not only what I'm doing, but it's them and their work ethic and what they've done on and off the field.
The Jacks are coming off an historic season in 2017, 11 wins in the program's first ever trip to the FCS semifinals. But this team has championship aspirations in mind, and Smith says the group didn't quite grade out as high as he would have hoped.
We could have been better because we were so young last year. Obviously, we lose Kellen, who played a lot of football for us, and then it was a big question mark going into last season. So now, going into year two, I feel a lot more confident about my guys. They know me, I know them, I know their strengths, what they need to improve on, and they work super hard to get better and understand what they need to do and hold each other accountable.
As Smith alluded to, the Jacks lose wrecking ball and three-year starter Kellen Solick to graduation. They do return Spencer Hildahl, who made 13 starts a year ago, and youngsters such as Xavier Ward, Thomas Stacker, Austin Barrett, and Crockett Krolikowski will need to step up in order to earn playing time.
Spencer Hildahl is doing a good job, really trying to lead the pack a little bit, and he has the most experience of everyone so far. Crockett has done a good job, a guy who hasn't played at all for us, but he made tremendous strides in the spring, and then, picking it up as we get deeper and deeper in fall camp. So he stood out in several ways in pass rush, been physical in the run, and then X has done a good job. He's not a puppy anymore. Last year he was just running around a little bit, didn't know what he was doing, and is kind of coming into his own.
Entering fall camp with an open starting position is actually something Smith and the group have looked forward to. He says the guys have embraced the challenge for who will start, and it's helped provide some depth as far as guys being prepared for September 1.
So a lot of guys get to rotate in to go with the first group, the second group, so they can go out there and compete every day versus the first O-line, two O-line, whoever they go against. So all four of those guys are going to play a significant amount of role for us, and we got a couple freshmen that came in. Caleb Sanders has really impressed me so far with what he's done. Coming from a high school level, that is a big transition, in high school football last year and stepping right in to play at this position, how physical it is. You could be going against 23-year-old men as an 18-year-old kid. So, he's held his own so far, and excited about his future as well.
This year, the goals for the defensive tackles are to get to the quarterback more and improve on the run defense, which ranked 7th last year in the Missouri Valley Football Conference. The tackles themselves recorded 10.5 sacks as a group last year. If they can improve in those areas, Smith says they can start to think about their season-end goals.
We got pretty lofty goals, obviously, to win a national championship for us, but taking it one game at a time, and to win a national championship, no matter what level you're at, it takes an elite defensive line and a great quarterback. And, we have a proven quarterback, but right now a lot of people probably wondering about the defensive line, and, they have that chip on their shoulder, wanting to be that group, the best defensive line in the Valley. That's the challenge that we have, is to be a presence, be physical, nasty, and that's what we want people to see when they turn the film on.